Hi guys, Joe Kelly here from the Instinctive Actor Society. If you haven't joined the Instinctive Actor Society private Facebook group, today's topic is going to be about your headshots and are they a hot mess or are you happy about it? And if you're here in the live or even in the recording, you can share in the comments how you feel about your headshots. The reason that I did this little training is because when I start working with actors, I often hear them having difficulty with their headshot sessions. So I hear things like, okay, well, it depends on the photographer. If the photographer's great, then I'm fine with my headshots. It's like, and there's two parts, right? Is do I enjoy them and do I actually get the result that gets me in the room? The type of headshots that are impactful enough so I get called in. So is it fulfilling? Is it fun? And is it impactful? Really, those are the two things that you want to look for. And so often, and most of the time, and I would say probably 95% of the time, I'm hearing it's really not fun because if the photographer is not in his zone or not nice, then I feel uncomfortable. Or I had a tough day before and I wasn't really able to, to be present. Or I didn't connect really with the makeup artist and the hair person, and so we weren't really aligned in what I was wanting. And I wasn't okay with the type of looks that they were suggesting, or the opposite. They weren't okay with the looks that I came in with that my agent told me I had to do. Or I feel like they don't really represent me. So they look good, but they don't really look like me. So when I get in the room, casting feels a little disappointed because that's not what they asked for. So the series of reasons why I hear actors not like taking their headshots is endless. It's really about how much pressure there is in the moment because it's expensive. And so you put the bar really high and you want everything to be amazing, and therefore you're expecting an outcome and you're not in the present moment. So if you're not in the present moment, you can't open. I get it. They are your most important tool as an actor. You need to have headshots that represent who you are and that get you called in so that you can go and audition. So it makes sense that you want to have a good time when you do them and that you want them to be great because you're putting time in it, money in it, and hope in them that they'll get you called in, right? So there's other things that I hear actors say, like I'm blanking right now, but yeah, it's gonna come back. But basically it's, oh yeah, like, I don't like to pose. I often hear that. I don't know how to, like, I hate doing headshots. Like, I have to pose and be there, and I'm an actor, I'm not a model, and so I don't really get it. Sometimes I work with models who are switching to acting, and they say the same thing. No matter how many photo sessions they had, they still feel like they're a little bit of a victim of the circumstances of if the photographer's going to be nice and make them feel comfortable, or are the other members of the shoot going to make them feel nice, or what, did I put too much money in it, or I didn't put any money in it, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So the list is endless. And so that's the reason why I wanted to do this little training, because I feel there's so much to gain from having an approach where you're actually the boss of your own headshots. And that you can have a good time as you do them, and that you can actually have the result that you need. If you haven't yet signed up for the Instinctive Actor webinar, get on the wait list. There's none now, but there will be one soon. And in the Instinctive Actors webinar, we really look at how to kind of reset your instrument to be in its instinct rather than in its head, right? To kind of move through the resistance so that you can show up and be open. And that would be the first thing that you would need to be present and open for your headshots, of course. But let me talk about The first thing that I want to talk about is the things that you do absolutely not want to do in a headshot session. So what you don't want to do in a headshot session, oh, that's a mouthful, headshot session, is you do not want to try and look good, right? It's not, a headshot session is really not about you looking a certain way, you looking good, because obviously we want your headshots to be authentic. We want you to look like you look so that when you get in the room, the casting director sees you. And if you embellish the headshots, if you're trying to look good in them, well, there'll just be a gap between who you appear to be in those headshots and who you end up showing up as. And that gap will not be a big satisfaction for the casting director, because they are on a, you know, on a whatever, they're on a time crunch too, and they need to get things done. And if someone is showing up that they didn't look for and didn't choose, it's kind of annoying for them. And I get that. So the other reason why you don't want to look good is that trying to look good is a little bit of a desperate endeavor. There's always someone who's going to look better if you're trying to look good, right? There'll always be the more this or that, more big, more small, nose more like this, more like that, like bigger boobs, smaller boobs, etc. So there's always going to be a better looking version, or a version that will please more that casting director or another. So it's just like an endless endeavor that leads you nowhere. So the big no-no is to try and look good. So another thing to do in the list of big no-nos that there is in this training that I love talking about is I always see actors take angles when they take their headshots. It has to do with posing, right? We're not posing, right? If I start doing things like this, I am manipulating your experience of me. I am trying to look good again, right? And this, you know, doesn't show who I am at all. It shows that I am posing. And so you cannot expect anyone to see who you are when you are diverging, one of those, your attention from who you are into a pose. So no posing, no looking good. This is who I am. I don't need to do that for you to see who I am, right? Or this or this or this or, you know, whatever it is. Just be here. Just let the viewer look into you. Don't tell them what you want them to see about you, because it's manipulative and it's fake and it doesn't work and it's really easily spotted. Determine your uniqueness. So as a human being, as an artist, you have essences that determine in a unique way who you are. We're all the same, and we're all extremely different and unique. And so what you want to shine through in your, not that you're gonna try and shine it through, but what you want to be apparent in your headshots is how unique you are. Doesn't mean that you're better or more special than anyone else. It just means this is who I am in this unique way. Again, it's not about good or bad or better or worse. It's this is who I am. So that's one of the steps too. Okay, crucial. And it goes back to the Instinctive Actor webinar if you haven't taken it. You really want to make sure that your instrument is open, right? And nothing will go like you want during your headshot session. You might have an accident on the way. You might be late. The photographer might be annoyed. You might have a fight with the hair or makeup person. You might have different perspectives and point of views. You might have an audition right after or right before, so you're not prepared. There's a million things that will be on your path, around your path, into your path, to your headshots. So you want to make sure that you have tools to really open your instrument no matter what is happening, to be there, Not to fake that you're confident. That's not what I'm talking about. Not to relax. Relaxing would be I'm feeling things, and so I'm going to numb those and show something because that's the thing that's working for everybody. That's people pleasing. Showing up confident or relaxed is people pleasing. It's not authentic. So it's really about how can I show up open, fully present, raw, real, authentic. So make sure you have tools about that too. And then last but not least, a mindset step. There are your headshot sessions. Tickling me for some reason. You're the boss of the freaking headshot session. You're the client. You're the one who's paying. So you need to act as the boss on the headshot session. You cannot be a little mouse that everybody is playing with on the headshot session. It's your headshot session. So there's a series of things that you prepare ahead of time to make sure you know what you're doing on your headshot session. And you make sure you're acting responsibly, like own responsibility, be responsible for everything that is happening on that headshot set so that it happens the way that you want it to happen. Because again, it's your headshot session. So prepare and work on those relationships and then act as the boss of those headshots. Well, thank you guys. Again, get in the comments if you have any questions. I'll check them later tonight in the Instinctive Active Society, because that's where we can take the discussion further and get connected and extend together. All right, thank you, bye.
So if you're interested in this and if this makes sense, if you wanna do this work, you can get on our wait list, you click the link below, and as soon as we open enrollment, we'll let you know.